These reports are about climate change. Climate change is a seasonal change over a long period of time. Climate change is a change in patterns.
So climate patterns play a fundamental role in shaping the natural ecosystem and the human economics and cultures that depend on them.
Estos informes son sobre el cambio climático. El clima es los cambios estacionales durante un largo periodo de tiempo. Y el cambio climático es el cambio con los patrones. Así que los patrones climáticos juegan un papel fundamental en la conformación del ecosistema natural y la economía y las culturas humanas que dependen de ellos.
Introduction. Nowadays, people are becoming more concerned with our average lifestyles. The current lifestyle of the average person is to use fossil fuels or other harmful chemicals to transport ourselves from place to place. Now monitoring the climate of our planet has become more crucial than ever. Satellites that have been launched in the past are giving us data that can tell us the current condition of Earth.
This project, we compare sea surface temperatures in different years and places.
The Pacific Ocean becomes warmer and the strips of blue become smaller.
This is a flow chart of the causes and effects of sea surface temperature.
The land surface temperature of the Pacific Northwest. In 2006, it was cold, and in 2009, it got colder. But in 2010, the temperature rises. Greenland's land surface temperature has its coldest in 2006, but by 2008, the temperature starts to rise.
Florida's climate is much more hot and humid than Alaska. During the month of April 2004, the state of Florida had little vegetation of
north of Jacksonville. If you look further south to Miami, though, the vegetation starts to grow and is significantly greater.
The average Florida temperature during April ranged from 52 to 72 degrees Fahrenheit. By June 2004, the vegetation shows a somewhat increase all around, but is still lit up by north close to Jacksonville. The Keys have the most vegetation around the whole United States at the time. Also the beginning of the most southern point of the U.S. The average Florida temperature during the month of June ranged from 68 to 79 degrees Fahrenheit.
This is a synthesis of individual student observations of the NEO images.
Many organizations, academies, and programs like TIPCO, NOAA, NASA, and the U.S. National Academy of Science use technology to find the land surface temperature and analyze them. Records show a temperature trend from 1880 to 1945 that started to rise, then declines a little until 1975, then it rose in temperature until now.
Before, when there was less urban industries, the temperature rise was slower rate, and mostly because of natural things like the amount of sunlight received and reflection. However, the data has shown that the temperature has increased starting mostly in the 20th century, when there were more urban industries. Urban industries have caused the heat island effect and have greatly contributed to global temperature increase. This is enforced by the fact that the past century temperature, the USA, increased at a rate of 0.11 degrees Fahrenheit per decade. But since 1976, the rate has increased to 0.56 degrees Fahrenheit per decade. Also, Earth's temperature increases is 0.25 degrees Fahrenheit per decade. Plus, the 8 warmest years in history have been from 2001 until now.
Overall, the increase in land surface temperature is due to global warming because of the greenhouse effect, and it's caused mostly by human activity. This is very bad because increase in global temperature is causing species of animals to become extinct and migrate from their homes. For example, in the Arctic, the sea ice is melting nearly because of the increase in temperature. This threatens the polar bear's life cycle because it reduces their hunting season to get food.
As students, we found that to make things, we also made gases that got to the atmosphere, which made it warmer.
Como estudiantes encontramos que para hacer cosas también hicimos gases que entraron en la atmósfera que lo hizo warmer.
In conclusion, this could all have a huge impact on global climate change because many areas which I observed were not always at the normal temperature for that certain area. This could impact our lives here at Earth because many people, such as farmers, need to know these temperatures in order to know how much water to give their crops so they don't suffer from heat stress. Also, if temperatures are too high or too low, it can make growing crops almost impossible, which can affect us greatly as well as many of the plants and animals on Earth.